Look at somebody and say, I hate to tell you this. I need you talking to your neighbor because everybody's asleep this morning. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I hate to tell you this, but there will be painful experiences. Joseph, in the beginning of Genesis 37, is a 17-year-old young man. And the only thing that got him in trouble and with all the tragedy he had to face was the same thing that got those 9 murdered in Charleston, South Carolina. I need y'all to hear me. The same thing that got Joseph thrown in a pit is the same reason why those 9 members of Emmanuel AME were murdered in Charleston, South Carolina. Can I tell you what it was? Color and a dream. Joseph's father in verse 3 of chapter 37 gave him a coat of what? Many colors. And because of the colors of the coat in the natural Hebrew, it says it was a long robe with sleeves. Because of the color of the coat, and his other brothers didn't have that color, they got jealous and envy of him because his father gave him a color that didn't look like theirs. Then, to make matters worse, not only does he have a different color from his other brothers, but he also had a dream in verse 5. And when he told his brothers about the dream, they literally got angry and hated him, became jealous of him, sold him into slavery because Joseph had color and a dream. Do you know in America, if you the wrong color and have a dream, life will become very dangerous for you? Don't y'all look at me like that this morning. See, y'all got the wrong one on the microphone. I ain't come to play this morning. Do you know being a Negro in America, even in 2015, you have to deal with stuff. We got to deal with stuff, not because we're stupid or ignorant, just because of the color. And don't mess around and have color and dreams. Do you know that bomb detonated in September 15, 1963, a few weeks after King shared his dream? When you walk around here and keep raising your children, when you walk around here and resist the foolishness in the media and tell your son, boy, pull your pants up. Ain't nothing wrong with you wearing your pants like that. But the problem is the media is already portraying us a certain way. And if you keep living into what we're portrayed as, they will mistake you for a thug, really, when you're an intelligent student. So here's what we're going to do. Since the world has already labeled us and stereotyped us, I refuse to give into the stereotype, and I am so sick and tired of our young brothers and our young ladies. I know you may not be able to speak correct English all the time. I know you can't dress perfect all the time, but let me tell you something. You did not come from anybody stupid, so don't act like you stupid when you have kings and queens in your history. Look at somebody and say, I still got a dream. I got a dream that our young girls are going to grow up to be great mothers. I got a dream that our young men are going to pull their pants up. They're going to pull their grades up. They're going to pull their head up. They're going to pull their life up, and they will be all right. I got a dream that the police will stop pulling us over just because we're driving while black. I got a dream that there be some peace in this land. Don't mess around and have color and a dream. Because the people that are supposed to be your brother without your color will hurt you for it. They talk about, well, maybe if our young men pull up our pants, the problem is this. Dr. King had a PhD at the age of 26 and wore suits every day. And they still killed him. So if I'm in a suit, I'm dangerous. If I'm studying my Bible in my church, I'm dangerous. Where can we be colored and dream-filled?